friends, welcome back to CENTUM Academy again. Today in this session, we are going to discuss the last part of the general organic chemistry, which is nothing but tautomerism. Okay? Tautomerism, you must have seen that this is a part of isomerism. It is given in isomerism. Okay? But since this particular isomerism, type of isomerism, requires the concept of this particular type of isomerism requires the concept of resonance. Okay, that's why we are discussing it here only. Okay, so here in this tautomerism, what is tautomerism? Tautomerism is a special type of functional isomerism. Special type of functional isomerism. Right? In which the two isomers exist in dynamic equilibrium. Equilibrium. Okay. The next point you have to understand here, these isomers are interconvertible and called tautomers. Okay, and that is why, and this phenomenon is tautomerism. Okay, for example, you see, if I take this molecule, this is example. Okay, this is keto form, ketone functional group, so keto form, and this is enol form. Why enol? Because this ene stands for double bond alkene, and this ol stands for this functional group, right? And this kind of conversion we call it as keto enol tautomerism. Keto enol tautomerism. Okay, so basically this particular type of isomerism, which is tautomerism, in this what happens, like suppose I have taken this example. Okay, one more example if I write down here for keto enol tautomerism. CH3 C double bond O CH3 CH2 double bond C single bond OH CH3. Okay, now in this example you see the second one, which is nothing but this CH2H here, C double bond O CH3, right? So in this hydrogen, which is adjacent to this keto group, whether this hydrogen or this hydrogen, this hydrogen is acidic hydrogen or reactive hydrogen, since this is present adjacent to the keto group. Because of the electron withdrawing nature of this C double bond O, this hydrogen can come out as H plus. Okay, now what happens, this this hydrogen, because of this electron withdrawing group, comes out and attach onto this oxygen, and we get CH2, double bond C, single bond OH, and CH3. This is how the reaction happens, right? And why it happens, since you have taken this molecule, that is acetone. If you take this molecule acetone into any bottle or any vessel, okay, closed vessel, right, then what happens after some time, at time t is equals to 0, right, there is only acetone present. So if I write down here, at t is equals to 0, this is 100% acetone, right, and there is no enol form, so 0% it is initially when you have taken this into a vessel, closed vessel, okay. At time t is equals to t, any other time, if you see, the content of this will less than 100%, and this content will be greater than 0%, right? Means few amount of this enol has been formed, right? And we are not doing anything into this, okay? This happens on its own, right? This is an spontaneous process, right? It is an spontaneous process. We are not doing anything into it. You take this acetone into a bottle, after some time you will get that few amount of enol is also there, right, and few amount of acetone is also there, right. The one which is more in the composition, that is more stable, like means whatever the molecule is more stable, the composition of that will be more into that vessel or bottle, whatever you are taking, right. So stability also we'll discuss in this, okay. And this kind of conversion, see, actually what happens when this H plus comes out, right, then this carbon has one lone pair negative charge on it, okay, and then this H plus has again the tendency to attach with this molecule again, right. So this H plus which is coming out can attach onto this carbon or on this oxygen also. Why on this oxygen? Because this oxygen has lone pair on it, right, so it can easily accept this H plus ion from this. Okay, so basically we have two points where this H plus can attach on this carbon or on this oxygen, right. So when this hydrogen comes onto this carbon, we'll get the same molecule, or when this hydrogen comes onto this oxygen, we'll get this molecule, okay. So this is, right, where this hydrogen will attach, that depends on the stability of this molecule or this molecule. Whichever molecule is more stable, there only H plus will attach, and that particular compound will be more in composition, right. So now a few more examples. If I write down, suppose if I take this example, oxygen we have here and double bond O, when you write down the enol form of this, we'll get OH here, and this oxygen will be here as it is, okay. Now you see, in all these examples, alpha hydrogen is must required, okay. So this hydrogen is alpha hydrogen, right, this is alpha position, right. Similarly here also this is alpha hydrogen, and here also we have alpha position, right. So alpha hydrogen shifts onto this oxygen, that is what is happening here in all this example, okay. So the condition is what, for tautomerism we must have at least one sp3 hybridized alpha hydrogen. That is the necessary condition. You must have at least one sp3 hybridized alpha hydrogen, correct. That is the condition we have. Now you see, this tautomerism can take place in acidic medium also and basic medium also, right. So what is the mechanism of those reactions in acidic and basic medium, that we are going to discuss now, okay. The first one we are looking at is base catalyzed mechanism. Okay, suppose the molecule I am taking is CH3, or I write down like this, CH2 hydrogen here, C double bond O, CH3. Okay, both are interconvertible, that's why we have taken the reversible sign here. So base is what? Base is, suppose we have OH minus, right? So what happens, this OH minus will take this alpha hydrogen, okay? This OH minus will take this alpha hydrogen, this bond pair comes over here and this bond pair will go on to this oxygen, okay? So the thing here, CH2 double bond, C single bond O with three lone pair CH3, okay? This step is the rate determining step, with the oxygen will have here the negative charge, okay? Now here what happens, the H2O, from this H2O, this will take this H plus ion and OH minus will come out. So finally this will convert into CH2 double bond, C single bond OH, CH3 plus OH minus. Okay, this is how the reaction proceeds for base catalyzed mechanism. One point is very important here for you to understand is, suppose since both side we have three alpha hydrogen, right? If one side we have like this, suppose we have R CH2 C double bond O CH3, then what is the product here we get? Okay, because both side we have two different number of alpha hydrogen. So in base catalyzed mechanism, hydrogen comes out from the carbon, alpha carbon, which has more number of hydrogen. So what happens, this is hydrogen and this hydrogen will come over here. So I'll write down RCH2 single bond COH double bond CH2. So in base catalyzed mechanism, hydrogen comes out from the carbon which has more number of hydrogen. Carbon means alpha carbon. Okay, this is what you have to keep in mind. So I'll write down here, note, H plus comes out from the carbon which has more number of hydrogen. Carbon means alpha carbon. Okay, in base catalyzed mechanism we have to take care of this thing. The next one is acid catalyzed mechanism. Acid catalyzed mechanism. In this one, I am taking the same example. Right? So H plus we have, and the lone pair of this oxygen will attack onto this H plus here. Right? We get CH2 single bond COH CH3 positive charge on oxygen, and here we have H. Right? Next, what happens? This pi electron will go here, and this pi electron go here. H plus will come out. Okay? So we'll get CH2 double bond C OH CH3. This is how the mechanism takes place in acid catalyzed reaction. Okay? Here, you have to keep this point in mind that H plus comes out from the alpha carbon, which has less number of hydrogen. Okay, this is the two mechanism we have. Okay, now in all this mechanism, because you don't have to draw this mechanism again and again in the exam. Okay, so what you have to keep in mind, suppose this is a first position, this is second, and this is third, right? Or here, this is again first position, second, and third. Right? Randomly, I am giving some number. I am assigning some number over here. Right? 1, 2, and 3. So, hydrogen comes out from the third atom, attach on the first, and there will be a double bond between second and three. Okay? Hydrogen comes out from the second, third atom, attach on the first, and there is a double bond between second and three. That is what the product we have here. Okay, or 1, 2, and 3, I'll write this side. Okay, 1, 2, and 3, I'll write this side. Okay, here it won't make any difference because both sides we have CH3. Okay, hydrogen comes out from the third atom, attach on the first, right, and there will be a double bond between second and third. This is what we have here. This is what you have to keep in mind. Okay, hydrogen comes out from the second atom, attach on the third, and then there's a double bond between second and third atom. Okay, now this is what the theory part we have of tautomerism, right? Depending on the stability of these two compounds, keto and enol form, the one which is more stable, the composition of that will be more in the mixture, okay, in the equilibrium mixture. Okay, so which one is more stable, and for stability, what are factors we have to consider, that we are going to discuss now, right? One thing I'll tell you, generally keto form is more stable than enol form. And why is it so? Because the C double bond O keto form is more stable than enol form. Okay? So, reason is what? The bond energy of C double bond O is more than the bond energy of C double bond C, or the bond energy of C single bond O. Right? So, this bond energy and this bond energy, the bond energy of C double bond O is more than this. That is why the keto form is generally more stable than enol form. But in few cases, for example, if I write down here, like this example, there are a few factors which actually affects the stability of keto enol form. For example, this one. The enol form of this will be what? The oxygen is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. This is sp3 hybridized, this is alpha carbon. Right? So hydrogen comes out from this 3, attach on the first. So we'll get here what? Hydrogen comes out from 3, attach on the first, and there is a double bond between second and third. These two pi bond already we have, right? So in few cases, like in this case, the enol form is more stable. Why this one is more stable here? Because of aromaticity. This is more stable, right? So this kind of factor if you have, then maybe stability will be different, but otherwise or generally keto form is more stable than enol form. Okay, we'll see now a few examples into it and then we'll discuss the stability comparison. Okay. Okay, so the next we are going to discuss the stability comparison of keto enol form. Keto-enol form. Case 1. There are few cases into it. We'll first discuss the case 1. When we have in case of monocarbonyl compound. Monocarbonyl compound. One carbonyl group will be here. For example, you see. The product here it will be right. This is keto and this is enol. The equilibrium mixture, if you see the composition of this enol form here, it will be 10⁻⁴%. This is very less at equilibrium. Because this molecule is more stable. And why it is more stable? Because of the same reason I have told you, that higher bond energy of C double bond O, right? And here the bond energy is less. Okay? So that's the reason. This is more stable form here. Now in second case, you see this one, double bond O, so its enol form will be OH. So this, the composition of this will be 1.2%. In this section, this composition is also important. It is the experimental value I am giving you. Okay, you have to memorize this. Okay, again, this is more stable at equilibrium. More stable, and this is more stable at equilibrium. Right? Okay, this is the first case when we have monocarbonyl compound, there is no exception, it is straightforward only. Okay, keto form is more stable. Okay, case 1, case 2, you see, when we have dicarbonyl compound, two examples I will take here. Suppose we have CH3. C double bond O, C double bond O, CH3, and the another one we have is these two. Okay, so here you see what happens in the first case. Okay, these two examples you see, here we have lone pair repulsion, lone pair on this oxygen, right, and lone pair on this oxygen. So here we have lone pair repulsion, right, and to minimize this repulsion, the two, one of this part, like the half part of this will rotate itself. So this double bond O will come to this side to minimize the repulsion. So we get here H2C H C double bond O C double bond O CH3. And when you write down the enol form of this, this hydrogen will come over here. So H2C double bond COH, C double bond O, CH3. Right? In this case, if you write down the product, we'll have OH here, here we'll have double bond, and here we have double bond O. Correct? Okay? This is alpha hydrogen, comes over here, and we get double bond here. This molecule is stable because of hydrogen bonding. Now, because of hydrogen bonding, this molecule is highly stable and its composition is around 100% here because of hydrogen bonding. So, this is one factor we have which influence the composition of this mixture. Because of hydrogen bonding, it is gaining stability, hence the composition of this will be more. In fact, it is 100% here. But here, since we have this repulsion and there is no such, hydrogen bonding possible here. So, if this two, if you compare, this one is more stable here, obviously, and the composition of this will be 0%. Means this reaction will not go in forward direction at all. Okay? This won't form actually. This is highly unstable molecule because of this C double bond O group here. Dicarbonyl compound. Okay? If you have dicarbonyl compound like this. Now, case 3 we have, which is 1,3 diketone, 1,3 diketone. For example, you see, what is 1,3 diketone? CH3, C double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. 1,3 diketone. Okay, so what happens here, you see, when you write down the tautomeric product here, this is alpha hydrogen, this is alpha hydrogen, for this molecule this is alpha, this is alpha, right? So what happens here, this alpha hydrogen will not take part in the reaction. This is methylene group, and when this methylene group is separated by two carbonyl group, right, then it is highly acidic. Okay, it is highly acidic, which is in between two carbonyl group, right, because both are electron withdrawing nature, both have electron withdrawing nature. So effect of these two group will be maximum here, right, in comparison to these two, and that is why this hydrogen is acidic here. So the product of this, if you write, that will be CH3 C single bond OH, double bond CH, single bond C double bond O, CH3. Right? Okay. The composition of this will be here around 76%. This composition you must remember, and why it is 76%, that also you can understand. This is active methylene group here, and if I write down this molecule as this, this carbon is here, C double bond C single bond OH, right, this C is here, double bond O, CH3 and CH3. Understood? If I write down random, if I do the numbering here, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So this carbon is 3, right? This is 4, and this is fifth carbon, right? This is one and this is two. This is what it is. Now in this case, what happens? This is stabilized by hydrogen bonding again. Because of this hydrogen bonding, this molecule is again more stable than the previous one, and that is why its composition is 76%. Okay, this composition is important. You must memorize this value. Okay, so whatever the composition, I am writing it down. It is important. Okay, you must write it down. Sometimes in the test, you will get in this in the matching column. Okay, the composition you will get in the matching column. I have seen few questions in JEE Advanced. Okay. So this composition you must remember. Experimental value I am giving you. You can compare logically which one is more stable, but composition you have to memorize. Okay. Another example we'll see. Next example you see, pH C double bond O CH2 C double bond O CH pH here. Now the product here we'll get is pH COH double bond CH single bond C double bond O pH. Okay, the composition of this will be 96%. You see here we have extended conjugation. Conjugation is here also, you see. Pi, sigma, pi, lone pair, sigma, pi. So this is, we have conjugation here, right? Here also we have conjugation, but because of phenyl group present both side, we have extended conjugation here. And that is why its composition is more. Extended conjugation gives more stability. So this is another example, 96%. Next example you see, if instead of this phenyl, if I put hydrogen, HC double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, H. The product here it will be HCOH double bond CH, single bond C double bond O, H. Right? Because of this minus M nature, this is also more stable and its composition will be 84%. Okay, this is 84%. So this 76, 84 and 96. This composition you must remember. Third example we'll see. CH3 C double bond O CH2 C double bond O, O C2H5. This you see, it shows minus M effect, electron withdrawing, minus M, minus I. Okay, this group is electron withdrawing. Because of this electron withdrawing nature, the tendency to lose this hydrogen atom will be comparatively less. We are comparing these molecules with this. Okay, so the product here we'll get is CH3 C single bond OH double bond CH single bond C double bond O O C2H5. So because of this electron withdrawing group, the composition of this will be lesser than the previous one and it is found to be 44%. Okay, so the value will be, this product is same, similarly the product will write, because of this group electron withdrawing nature, the tendency to lose this hydrogen as H plus will be less, and hence it is plus M and minus I, right? Plus M and minus I, electron releasing tendency. Tendency to lose H plus will be less over here. Electron, because of this lone pair you see, it has electron releasing tendency, and hence tendency to lose H plus. Here it will be less, hence composition will also be less. It shows minus I also, but plus M will be dominant here. Another example you see. Hydrogen bonding is not possible here in this case because of the steric repulsion. The repulsion in this methyl group, okay, and the composition of this is found to be only 7%. Because of steric hindrance, again another factor, because of steric hindrance, the composition decreases, stability decreases, composition decreases. Even if you further increase the size of this group, the composition will be less over there. So when the size of this group is more than the methyl group, the composition will be even less than from 7%, right? So that is the another case. Steric hindrance is the another factor, right? I'll write down here, because of steric hindrance. Few more examples we'll discuss. These are the three examples you see. Now from this, if I write down the product here, the product will be this double bond OH. Here the product will be OH double bond. Here the product will be this. Okay. Now you see it has 4 pi electron and hence it is anti-aromatic. And anti-aromatic is highly unstable, composition will be 0%. Right? It has 6 pi electron aromatic and this composition will be 100% since aromatic compounds are highly stable. Right? It has 8 pi electron anti-aromatic, highly unstable, composition will be 0%. Okay, so this is it for this tautomerism part. Okay, we have seen how to compare the stability of various, you know, various compounds, various ketoenol form, right? Those factors are hydrogen bonding, steric hindrance, aromaticity, right? And then resonance also is one of the factor. Extended resonance we also have seen, right? These 3-4 factors you must keep in mind whenever you have to, you know, compare the stability of tautomeric structures. All those examples and the composition that I have written, you must remember those composition. It is important. Again, I am telling you, in few questions I have seen, they have given the composition value also, the percentage value also, right? So that is it for this particular session. We are done with tautomerism. GOC is finished now. This is the last portion. Okay. We'll see you next into the another chapter. Thank you very much.